During the meeting, which included district engineers, leaders, journalists, and some stakeholders from Kagulube, Sarah Nanyanzi, the deputy resident district commissioner for Kalangala district, tasked officials to explain why water is not flowing, yet the sprinklers were installed.
Buli kiseera mutuyite mu meeting ne mutuuza wali ku musana ne tubeera ng'abasibu abantu mu nnimiro teri kiriyo mutulambuza ne tuva eno ne tutuuka eri tewali kiriyo ku ssente za gavumenti kumuzannyi.
Rajab Semakula, the Kalangala district chairperson, noted that projects that are usually managed by the ministries in Kalangala do not succeed.
What can you tell the community that we have discussed very good ideas? Tomorrow you will see. Now wait for 2 months ahead and you come back in April, in August, that the police will fail. Because this year, the trend has been, you see, you come back after 8 months, 6 months. We forget all we discussed previously at the start of this.
Today we can be sure.
I think she was not around. She had just come. I think she was not around when we presented to us.
Because that's the reason we are in this meeting.
Area leaders narrated how residents are being affected by this stalled project.
We are remaining with a balance of 45 million, but the project has not yet started working. So we are still looking at the government, and we are requesting the government to come and find out what is really taking on the ground.
We request the Ministry of Water to come down and sit with our local technicals at the Water Department. We get the total solution with them, because they have the capacity. Our engineers here at the ground, they have that capacity. If you combine the knowledge, the minister and the local engineer of water, you can get a solution, because some of the issues have come up whereby our engineer of water was issuing some issues to see the capacity of the engineer he's having to settle the water issues of the project.
Joseph Waswa, the manager of water production under the Ministry of Water and Environment, promised that the ministry is taking on the construction works in order to make this project functional by April 2023.
We take over, and our plan is that by April 2023, we shall be able to plan for the site handover. That's our plan as the ministry. Also as the ministry, there are other projects that we would like to start in Kalangala. The other project is Nalamagonja. Now this is going to be funded under the Badea project scheme.
The district chairperson appealed to the government to blacklist Awika for not completing the project meant to benefit the farmers in time.
Money, which should not be joked like that. We want the government to blacklist Awiko, or look for Awiko or the directors of Awiko company to compensate, because this irrigation project was targeting food security. When you talk about food security, it is about the lives of the populations in the country. Therefore, he should either be blacklisted and be forced to compensate the taxpayers' money, because at the end of the day, the taxpayer will pay that money.
Construction of Kagulube Irrigation System commenced on September 10th, 2019 under Awiko Engineering Company Limited and was supposed to be complete in 8 months. Story by Samuel Nkuba for the news.